I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
It's your birthday today, so I'm just going to sing you a little birthday song. And it goes something like this. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Have a very happy birthday. And just because it's our birthday, especially for you, I'm going to do a little happy dance, like this.
once again, we are back with the morning show and our daily devotion. And today it's called I'm Going To. So in the book of Ruth, Ruth explains to her mother-in-law, Naomi, that she loves her and will stick with her through thick and thin, even though her husband, Naomi's son, has died. So now that's a great friend. And we're going to talk today about how to be a good friend. So not long ago, there was a rumor that I heard about a friend of mine, and people said that he was talking about me behind my back. And at first that really upset me and it made me mad. And I believed the rumor without even stopping to think that it might not be true. And that's a flaw that we all have. I should have remembered what a good friend that he was, and that he'd always stuck by me through a lot of stuff that I've been through in our, you know, we've been through together as friends in our adult life, and that he's always been there to help me when I needed it. So there was no reason for me to doubt his friendship, except for that false rumor that I heard. So I did have a conversation with him and, you know, and asked him to forgive me for believing that, because I did find out later on that it was just a rumor. But that story, when I thought about that, it reminded me of a situation that I dealt with here at school not very long ago, last school year. And one of the things that was going on is there were friends that were not getting along so well, and one was saying things that weren't so nice about the other. Two mutual friends that they had. And one of the things that these mutual friends were doing is, and they were going back to that person and telling that person what was being said about them. And they did it because they thought they were being good friends. And they thought they were protecting their friend by saying, hey, this person is saying these bad things about you. And just like in my situation, they believed it. And whether it was true or not, sometimes we do get upset with our friends and we might say things. But when we hear someone saying mean things about one of our friends, the last thing we should do is go to that person and tell them what's being said about them. Because all that does is hurt our friend. It hurts their feelings. It does not protect them. It does not help them in any way. What helps them is if someone is talking about someone that you care about, someone who's a friend of yours, this is where you need to say, you know what, don't talk to them about me like that. I don't want to hear about them in that way from you. They're my friend and I care about them and I don't want to hear bad things about them. And then don't tell your friend, because they don't need to hear the bad things. What needs to happen is that you stop the negativity as best you can on your end. A true friend won't share negative or bad things that they hear people say about you. A true friend will tell that person not to talk about you in that way. A real friend is a forever friend, not just for a summer or until you get out of the class that you have together. A real friend is loyal and faithful, and God is that kind of friend as well. He never leaves us. Ruth understood this kind of faithfulness. I think that's why she wanted to do for Naomi what God had done for her. So what I want you to do now is think about two of your closest friends. What do you like about them? And what do you think they like about you? So sometime today, call or text your best friend and share how much you appreciate them. But do not do it during class. Do not do it during class. Do it during lunch or do it after school. But I want you to go ahead and do that and let them know how much that you do appreciate them. Now go out into the world, Sea Shepherds, and be better today than you were yesterday.
Please make yourself comfortable in your seat and close your eyes. Take in a deep breath, and as you breathe out, feel your body begin to relax. I would like you to imagine that you can see the number 10. Just visualize in your mind. If you cannot see the number 10, just say the word to yourself in your mind, 10. Now choose a color. What color is number 10? Perhaps there is a fragrance that comes to mind with this number. Or a sound, any sound you like. Now, we're going to change to number 9. What color is number 9? Perhaps a sound, a fragrance, a shape, a size. What comes to you when you imagine number 9? And as we go down the numbers, I will say the number to you, and you will imagine a color, a shape, a size, a sound, a fragrance, whatever comes to mind, no effort. And as we go down the numbers, you will become more and more relaxed and clear, and you will feel just wonderful. 8. Imagine the number 8. And now 7. 6. 5. 4. More and more relaxed. 3. 2. 1. What color is number 1? What is the size? Is there a fragrance? A sound that comes to your mind? Now let the numbers go. Let them just fade away out of your mind and be just comfortable and relaxed in your seat. And when you're ready, you're going to take a deep breath. And as you breathe out, have a gentle stretch, whatever feels comfortable for you right now. And you're feeling energized and confident and ready to enjoy a wonderful day.